Welcome back to Masons and Their Music. Companions, you may have wondered why in July didn't we have something about the national anthem and the flag. That's because we wanted to save it until September, because that's when the national anthem was actually written. What was Francis Scott Key, who was a lawyer and an insider in Washington and known as Frank Key, doing in the Baltimore Harbor while the British were bombing Fort McHenry? Well, as it turns out, he wasn't a very big fan of the War of 1812 and thought it was unnecessary, but President Madison asked him to go to Baltimore and secure a prisoner release. There was a physician who stayed behind at the Battle of Bladensburg to attend to the wounded on both sides, and was taken by the British aboard the Admiral's ship and kept in very comfortable quarters in return for his service both to British and American troops at that battle. So Francis Scott Key boarded a sloop and headed around into Baltimore Harbor to have a meeting with the Admiral of the British Navy, who was there to discuss getting the doctor returned from captivity with the British. And the Admiral invited him to dinner on board his flagship, and the doctor and Francis Scott Key and the Admiral dined and very convivially agreed, "We'll set the doctor free and you as soon as we finish bombing your fort. So we're going to put you on a sloop out of harm's way." It was there on a piece of scrap paper witnessing the bombing of Fort McHenry that Francis Scott Key penned the lyrics to what became our national anthem. And by the way, if you ever go to the Natural History Museum and see that huge woolen flag, that was the battalion flag at Fort McHenry, but it didn't fly over Fort McHenry the night of the bombardment because there was a tremendous thunderstorm, which is what eventually caused the British to stop the bombardment. And if it had been soaked with rain, it would have snapped the pole. So a different flag flew, but that was the Fort McHenry flag that you see when you go to that museum. Our national anthem's music was not written by an American, but by John Stafford Smith, a member of the Inverness Lodge of London. So an Englishman provided the tune for Francis Scott Key's lyrics. It was actually a British drinking song. I don't know if there's any irony in that or not. I also believe that the most magnificent rendition of our national anthem was done by Whitney Houston at Super Bowl. And again, using our Bluetooth speaker, here is our national anthem as performed at Super Bowl. Thank you. Francis Scott Key's lyrics, John Stafford Smith's melody, Whitney Houston's voice, their companions, is your national anthem. We'll see you next month when we revisit Masons and their music.